Welcome to today's lesson. So we are looking at mathematics for grade 9 and our topic for today is computer and calculator. So please pay attention. This is a question that comes in the exam year in, year out since it was introduced. So as I'll be teaching the grade 8s and 9s, the seniors can also benefit because these will serve as their basics. Okay, so now to begin with, a computer is simply an electronic device that is capable of accepting data, processing it and giving it out, or even storing it for the future. So now that is a computer. For example, you can have a laptop. A laptop is capable of, you can put in some information, it can process it and it can store it. Even a mobile phone is also a computer. So there are a lot of things about a computer. So you have to know the inputs and the outputs of a computer. An example of an input is a keyboard, a mouse, or even a sticker, for example, a flash disk. Those are the things that you are putting in. So that is an input. Okay, then we also have outputs. So outputs are things that the computer is producing. After the computer has processed, then it will produce some outputs. Okay, so now today we are very much interested in looking at the exam kind of questions that come, and these are the four basic symbols of a flowchart. So we are going to look at a flowchart. So just by definition, a flowchart is a graphical representation of the problem solving process. So a flowchart is something that we're going to form by connecting one of these four symbols with arrows so that it can make sense and we solve a problem. So for a starter, the most important things that you have to know about computer and calculator is these four symbols, as you can see on the board here. So we have this one here, which is the oval shape. This one simply means start or stop. Then we have this one. This one is the input or output. So the things that you are putting in, those are what you write in here. Then the things that the computer is going to display, that is what you also put in here. Then we also have this shape here, which is the action box. So the action box, this is where the performance is done. And usually this one here is where we put the formulas. Okay, then this question here, this is the decision box, the thinking box as others call it. So this is where we put questions. You are trying to decide something. Should I do this or should I do this? If I do this, then that is going to happen. So we put those in a decision box. Okay, so let's now look at a practical scenario where we can apply the knowledge that we have now about these four shapes. So we switch to this other board here, the sample question, which has been extracted from 2018 paper 2 for the juniors, which is grade 9. So it says, give the distance D covered by a car and the time T the car takes to cover this distance. Okay, complete the flow chart below for calculating and displaying its average speed. So the main point that we have here is the average speed. So before you can start plugging in your inputs, you don't know what you're going to input so that you get speed. Now you have to know the formula for speed, and the formula for speed is equals to distance over time. So this is the formula for what? For speed. So now one thing you have to know is that in order for you to get speed, you will need to have the value of a distance. Okay, the value of distance. Then you also need to have the time given to you. So when these are given to you, that is when now you can have the result. So in your computer here, what you're supposed to put in is, when you put in D and T, then you'll be able to get what? Speed. So like I said, this one, it means the start. It has been started for you. So this one is the input. So what do you need to input in order for you to get the speed? What you need is this one and that one. So you are going to write in here, input D T. So that is what you're writing in there. Then this one is the action box, as you can see there. So the action box, as shown here, I said here, simply put a formula. So you are going to write your speed is equals to distance over time. Okay, then this one, we said it means two things, input and output. So for the input, we've already put here. Then now we are going to do the output, which is in here. So what are we outputting? So what we are outputting is the average speed. So here we are simply going to write display display speed.
So that is how it is done. So please, you can contact us for more information. Otherwise, with questions regarding computer and calculator, you are well covered. You can try check out 2019, check out 2017 and other papers. Otherwise, thank you for listening to this lesson. Till next time.